I'm greeting the young men. What I'm preaching to you tonight, the topic tonight is appearance denies identity. Hallelujah. In John 18:36, Jesus says, well, my identity is where I'm from is, well, my kingdom is not an earthly kingdom. Jesus has already answered this. And it becomes a challenge for us. He challenges the people that are religious. He challenges the people who expect the Messiah to come in a certain way. Jesus, can we open in the book of Luke?
I'm
preach the gospel to the poor. And if it was me, Bazalwane, sitting there, I would be like, yo, this guy, where's God? Like, he has, like, the Spirit of God is anointed. What is he talking about? His father is a carpenter. And then now he appears and tells me that he has to preach the gospel to me. I mean, Bazalwane, in those times, okay, yes, they were expecting the Messiah. But then if it was you, someone coming to you and say, well, I have to come to you and preach the gospel, I'm anointed, I'm going to die for your sins. That's why they're asking, isn't this Joseph's son? Mm. But then are you going to allow people to define you according to how they see you? Mm. According to how you appear? Yes, he raised me. Joseph is my father. He raised me. But then he doesn't own my identity. Mm. I appear from him. He's my father. He raised me. But then are you going to allow people to limit you to how you are? Hallelujah.
Amen.
1 Peter 2.
Thank you.
accepted, it affects everything in my life.
Sure.
Your career,
yeah.
It affects the way you appear, the way you want to wear. You want to wear like everybody else. If you wear something that is different, you are not accepted. The Bible says you are chosen. You are chosen. So God knew that you will, somehow you will fail me, but then he has chosen us. That means we are accepted. He accepted us as we are. He knows that he has given flesh, Basala. He has given us flesh. He knows that, that flesh I've given you, it's going to fail you.
Amen.
But then he said, I am accepting you. I have chosen you. Amen.
Amen. John 15:19, it says, if you belong to the world, it would love you as its own. As it is, you do not belong to the world, but I have chosen you out of the world.
Yes.
That is why the world hates
you. The world hates you. Do not accept, do not expect to be accepted in the world. Do not try to make yourself be accepted.
Sure.
You're a child of God, you want to be accepted. Like, I know a lot of people say, well, you don't have to be too strict about the word of God. You won't be accepted. They won't listen to you.
Yeah, well.
You have to go with them to the parties so that they can hear you. No! The Bible says that the world did not accept me.
Yes.
Do not expect the world to love me.
Yeah.
It didn't know me. Why should they know me?
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Sure.
The second mark that is part of your identity is that the Bible says you are a holy nation.
Yes.
And it says that you are God's very own possession. You belong to God. And the third one, I just want to explain that you are extremely valuable. You are extremely, but you are not just vulnerable. You are extremely valuable. Hallelujah. Somebody say, I'm valuable. The word holy and the word belonging. Okay, let me explain holy first. Holy. Amen. Holy is when you are without fault. When we say the holy Bible, it's very valuable. Something that is priceless.
Yes.
Holy Bible, holy city, holy anything. God says we are holy.
Yes.
Amen. We are more than normal to him.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
So the word belonging. Amen. We are belonging to God. Have you realized when something, let's take it to clothing. If my clothing were to be from Beyonce, it was going to be? It was going to be expensive. So who? The question is like, who do you belong to? Because if you belong to the Father, you are extremely valuable.
Yes.
I don't know if you understand me. You are priceless. You are sanctified, set apart.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
And God is saying to us, well, you are my child. And I say to you, you are holy. Irrespective of how you appear, irrespective of how you fail,
sure.
Irrespective of how you fail me at the end of the day, you are still holy. You belong to me. So, because we belong to the Father, Deuteronomy 7:6, because we belong to the Father who is the King, then that means we are extremely valuable because God is valuable. He's extremely holy. And it's very, very low. There is nowhere that you can find God except in Christ.
Yeah.
Look at Christ showing his love to us. God showing his love to us. In the cross, it all points out to him. Not you, not how you appear. It's not about how you appear. It's about Christ. Hallelujah. Deuteronomy 7:6.
The Lord your God has chosen you out of all the peoples on the face of earth, to be his holy, to be his people, his treasured possession.
Amen. So we are God's treasure. Amen. Because he is our Father. He says, I'm your Father, then you are my treasure. Hallelujah. Luke 12:24. The Bible tells us that God is actually saying that, well, look at the birds. They don't plant, they don't do anything, but then I feed them. What about you? Because you are more valuable than birds. I will provide.
Yes.
That's your identity.
Sure.
That's part of your identity. He will provide. You are extremely valuable. You do not have to perform your way to God. You are extremely valuable. Hallelujah. Imagine, Bazalani. I would say, well, Asha, can you please give me a cold drink? And then they bring me a cold drink with their hands. Yeah, now you're thirsty. Can you? Yes. The first question that I'm going to ask is, where is the can? Well, the can does not get value from itself. It gets value from what? No matter how you look good, no matter how bad you look, it does not have anything to do with you. Well, valuability is found inside you.
Forgiven.
Hallelujah. We are not forgiven partially, but he has given us forgiveness. Hallelujah. Yeah. Romans 8:1 says that there is no condemnation for those who are in Christ.
Yeah.
But that's not a ticket for us to sin. Besides, you love you don't know, people you don't mix with, people who do not know Christ at all, people who do want to be here. In the book of, I think this one we all know, Acts chapter 1 verse 18, you shall be witnesses to the world. Amen. Can you read it? Amen. I just want to take out something from it. Acts chapter 1 verse 8. But you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes upon you. And you will be witnesses, telling people about me everywhere in Jerusalem, throughout Judea, in Samaria, and to the ends of the world. Well, I think we all know that the power, the word power from the scripture, it comes from the word dunema. And it is the power to do marvelous things. Hallelujah. He's saying that you are going to be witnesses to this power. You're going to witness this power to the people in Judea. Judea are people who are familiar to us. People that we mix with, people that we talk to, people that are not oppressed at all. Us. We know Christ. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
But you are going to witness this power to the people. You are the one who are going to preach this gospel. Because clearly the Bible tells us that we are ministers. In 2 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 6, from 5, it says, our confidence, our capability, our qualification is found in Christ.
Yeah.
To do what? To minister the new covenant. It's not because of you. Sometimes you won't even, some people won't even come and stand here in front and preach. But then you are a minister. Ministering doesn't mean you have to preach. You have to come here and preach to us. No. You are witnesses for me in the whole world, in Judea, and it says in Samaria. Samaria are those people that we don't even talk to. The Samaritan woman, remember? We don't talk to people who have tattoos everywhere, you don't even want to mix yourself with. People who get high almost every single day. Hallelujah. Those people want to hear the gospel from you. He says you are going to be witnesses to this power. When the Holy Spirit comes to you, we have already received the Holy Spirit. You've accepted Christ. And he says, the only thing that we have to do is to activate the Spirit within us. The Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is such a gentleman. He cannot force himself to. He cannot say, well, wake up, Ematandeni. We have to go and do the work of God. No, you have to. The Holy Spirit is such a gentleman, like you. He opens the door for you and he doesn't force himself to you. Like, he doesn't force himself. He wants you to give him the attention that he deserves.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Sometimes we feel like, well, I'm not capable. Hey, I'm shy. I can't. Feelings lie. Feelings lie. Are you going to listen to your feelings or listen to what God says about you? He says you are completely and fully capable.
Amen.
Our confidence is found in Christ to minister the new covenant. Hallelujah.
Amen.
God has given us this power to minister to the people. Amen. The homosexual, those that we don't want to talk to, those we don't even, like when someone sees you walking with that person, you feel like, no, this is not me. This is not me. Like, no. But those people would want to hear the word of God from you. You are a minister of God. You are a witness of Christ himself. The Bible says that he is living in us. Amen. The old man is dead. The new has come. Amen. Hallelujah. Jesus goes and speaks to, I am finishing?
Yeah.
Jesus goes and speaks to the Samaritan woman. People, the Jews, they don't even talk to. Amen. The Jews don't talk to those people, the Samaritan. He goes and speaks to the Samaritan woman. And then this very Samaritan woman goes and tells people in the village that, hey, there's a man who have prophesied. There's a man, I've given water, and guys, it's amazing how he prophesies. Like, he says that I have five men, nobody knows. the people that you do not want to tell the word of God with, you do not want to share the word of God with, the people that you do not mix with, are the very people that when they catch the glimpse of the kingdom of God, when they catch the glimpse, just the glimpse of the kingdom of God, when they catch the love of God in you, they go and tell everybody else. But you have denied them the opportunity to know Christ and go and tell everybody else. We are so content in church. We feel like equipment is found in church. We are here, Bazalwane, to get refreshment and go back and tell the people of the to come here like you are sitting. Hallelujah.
Amen.
As I finish,
can I continue?
The topic was appearance denies identity. It has nothing to do with your it has nothing to do with your appearance. Where you are from is where you are from. Whether you look like a Chinese person who is from Kian, it doesn't matter.